Hi, it's Brandon from soldwithvideo.com, and I want to show you how to make a Facebook landing page. Hey everybody, it's Brandon from soldwithvideo.com, and I'm going to show you guys how to set up a custom landing page on your Facebook profile. You can use these custom landing pages in a number of different ways. You can use them to show videos, you can use them to host opt-in forms, try to gain more leads. You can use them to get more likes and followers to your Facebook profile. You can use them to promote products, to show off your products, to try even sell products, or even get people to go over to your website. There's a lot of different ways you can use them, and all you need to do is add an HTML and some CSS or even Java code, and you're all set. So let's just get right into it. So the first thing we need to do is install the static HTML iframe tab app. And to do that, you can just go to the search bar and type in static HTML iframe tabs, and you'll see it right here with the star icon. We'll go ahead and click on that, and it'll pull up the static HTML page. So all you need to do is click the button that says add static HTML to a page. We'll click it, and this next page will appear. And you have the option of adding it to any page you're an admin on. So I'm on several of them here. So I'm going to go ahead and choose soldwithvideo.com. And then we're going to click on the Add Static HTML Iframes tab. So now it should be added to our tabs bar. But as you can see, I already have four tabs here, taking up all four available spots for the first row. So what's going to happen is Facebook is going to put it at the bottom row in the last available spot, which you can see here. And you can change it at any time. So if we want to go ahead and move it around, we can click on the pencil icon. You choose swap with, as you can see here, swap with, and you choose the app you want to switch it with. So let's just switch it with my discount code app. And as you can see, it switched it. So you can move them around any way you want. So I'm going to go ahead and move it back just for these testing purposes. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is change out the thumbnail and the tab name. So what we're going to do is hover over the icon, we're going to hit the pencil icon, and we're going to choose Edit Settings. So the first thing we want to change is the tab image. We're going to hit Change, and it's going to open up a new window. This will allow us to add in any image that we want in place of their star thumbnail. The image size is going to be 111 by 74 pixels. That's your maximum size. If you go bigger, it will resize it and convert it down. I recommend using 111 pixels by 74 pixels. So I've already have one pre-made, so I'm going to hit Choose File, choose my thumbnail, and upload it. Now I'm going to close that page, and I'm going to hit OK. And you guys, you can see it changed it for us. So now we have our custom image in there. So now we're going to change the icon name. So we're going to go back over, hit the pencil icon, go to Edit Settings. And as you can see right here, it says Custom Tab Name. All you need to do is fill in the custom name you want and hit Save and then OK. So let's just put in Custom Name. We're going to hit Save. We're going to hit OK. Boom, you're done. The custom Facebook landing page and the custom name have been switched out. Now we're going to move to the most important step, which is adding in the code for the page. To do this, all you need to do is click on the image and you'll be brought to the edit page. On the edit page, you'll be able to add in public content and even fans only content. So what's going to happen here is the public content is going to be the page that everyone sees, fans or non-fans. You have the option of adding in content that only your fans will see. And there is a benefit to this. If you create a landing page, you have the option of telling people to like your page, or if they already are fans of your page, to see certain content. So I'm going to show you guys an example of how I use this on our Sold With Video site. So as you can see here, I have an icon that says get a discount on your next order. And I'm going to have people click it and tell them here that if they want to get a discount on their next order, all you need to do is like our page. I have an arrow pointing up to the like. So they're going to go ahead and like the page. And when they do, they're redirected to a page that only our fans see. So now it says, thanks for liking our page. You can get a discount on our orders here. And they can come in here and get a discount on our order. So anytime a non-fan goes to our page, We give them an incentive to like our page, and when they do, they're rewarded with a discount code. Now, if someone goes to the page and is already a fan, they're just automatically brought to the thanks for liking our page and get their discount code. So you have the option here with this static HTML app. You don't need to do it that way. You can have one page that everyone sees, like if you're trying to promote a product or you have an opt-in form or something like that. You can just, all you need to do is just add your code to the public content. So what I'm going to do first is actually go to a page I have on my website. It's a landing form that I have on my website. I'm just going to take the HTML code from that and put it into the public content just to save on time so I don't have to custom code this. So I'm going to grab my code. And I'm actually going to just go back and write into public content. I'm going to paste all of my HTML code, as you can see right there. Now, the important thing is if you're just going to do what I did and grab code off of your site, make sure all of the URLs are full URLs. Sometimes you might get a URL that looks like that. You don't want that. You want to make sure the entire URL is posted in there. So now that our code is posted in there, we can hit preview to see a sample of what it's going to look like. So as you can see, we have a video that plays and an opt-in form to try to collect leads and get people to sign up for our newsletter. So now what we're going to do is go back to the Edit tab, and you can hit Save and Publish, and now our landing page should be live. So what we're going to do is go to the Sold with Video Facebook page. We're going to hit the tab. We're going to go to Custom Landing Page. And boom, we have a custom landing page using an opt-in form to try to get leads off of Facebook. And now we can set up an ad on Facebook targeting business owners and have them redirected to this page and then collect all the leads that come in from the opt-in form. You could do the same. You can use these pages to promote products. So you can run an ad promoting a product and bring them to a custom landing page similar to this. You can create almost any type of landing page you want. So let's go back to the edit page. The static HTML app actually has a few tools that you can use to custom create this if you're not familiar with HTML code. You can also upload an image. So if you have a JPEG or PNG or GIF file, you can actually upload it there and have the image displayed to all of your people visiting your landing page. You're also able to add in more tabs. So if you want to add in a few more custom tabs, you hit the Add Tabs button here. You can add in a second, third, fourth, as many as you want. And then you even have the option to add in more settings. So you can go through here and add in more settings if you like. You can add in Google Analytics. So you just put in your analytics code to get analytics on how people are getting to your site, who was there, how much time they spent on it, etc. They also have a whole bunch of how-to tutorials for you to go through if you run into any problems. They also have a drag and drop feature to custom design the tab, which will help you out. And scroll down here. They also have the area here for your fans' content. So you can have non-fan and fan content like I showed you earlier. If you not put any content in the fans-only content box, everyone visiting your landing page will see the page that you have listed here. So that's our tutorial on how to set up a custom landing page on your Facebook profile. Thanks for watching our tutorial. And if you found this information useful, you should join our newsletter at soldwithvideo.com, and you can see the sign up form about halfway down the page. And we'll send you more marketing information like how to get a video ranked in Google, how to get more exposure on YouTube, and even how to get mobile versions of all of your videos. And if you have a friend that's not taking advantage of custom landing pages on Facebook, send them this video. Copy the URL, send it on Facebook, Pinterest, Twitter, Google+, or even just email it to them. And if you like this video, let us know. Leave us a comment underneath or slam that like button down. And make sure you don't miss out on any of our future videos. All you need to do is hit the subscribe button here, and you'll be notified when our next videos are ready. Thanks again for watching, and this is Brandon from soldwithvideo.com signing out.